Heavens, you have done it. You have retrieved the Lord Vessel. After 1,000 years, it is you. It is really you. Forgive me. I really should calm down. Now, let us take that vessel on a journey. I assume that you are ready. Now, be still. Successor of Lord Gwyn. Now, place the Lord Vessel on the altar. As King Seeker, I shall now instruct you, the Lord's successor, in your next task. To achieve your fate, fill the vessel with powerful souls, commensurate to the great soul of Gwyn. Scarce few possess such brilliant souls. Grave Lord Nito, the Witch of Isolith, the four kings of New Londo, who inherited the shards of Gwyn's soul, and Lord Gwyn's former confidant, Seath the Scaleless. All of their souls are required to satiate the Lord Vessel. Are you ready? Then we shall return. Stay still for a moment. Is it something urgent? The beings who possess these souls have outlived their usefulness, or have chosen the path of the wicked. As the primordial serpent, I implore you to defeat them and claim their souls. Let there be no guilt. Let there be no vacillation. Farewell. Chosen undead, I remain here and await thee.
Of Astora. If you require smithing, then speak to me. Most weapons and armor are mighty sturdy indeed, but every hunk of metal has its breaking point. If you notice durability running low, it's time to repair. You can ask a blacksmith like myself, or do it on your own with a grindstone. The nice thing about weapons, they never betray you, so pay them a little respect, eh? There are two types of weapon forging. There's reinforcement and there's ascension. Reinforcement is simple. It strengthens the weapon and nothing more. A simple task for any blacksmith. Hell, you could even do it yourself with a smith box. But ascension's a finer art. It alters a weapon's properties. Ascension is the territory of we blacksmiths. A smith box just won't do the trick. Start out with reinforcement. When that loses its charm, you can consider ascension. As you've noticed, this land is flush with the mad and wicked. You won't make it through the night without employing my services. I'll be seeing you then. Be careful out there. Ah, why, that's a fine ember you have there. I could smith some mighty weapons with one of those. Why not lend it to me? Magnificent! Won't be disappointed. I can hardly wait to get started. I'll be seeing you then. Be careful out there. out there. I've seen one of those before. It's the ember of a divine blacksmith. Might you consider leaving that with me? I could produce divine weapons with a flame such as that. Well, thanks for that. You've made a fine decision. You soon shall see. I'll be seeing you then. Be careful out there.
So, 'tis thou who rescued me. Most gracious, I am deeply obliged. I am Dusk of Ulysium. I cometh from an age long before thine. I cannot stay here for long. So, before I disappear, allow me to ask one thing. My home, Ulysium, is the home of ancient sorceries. My hope is to pass this profound knowledge to thee with thine approval. Would this be of assistance to thee? My heartfelt thanks. I am pleased beyond words. Then I shout, engrave my signature. If thou art in need, pray summon me from my signature. Seems that my time is done. May the great flames guide thee.
Thank you.
So you have received a revelation. Very auspicious. I hope for the best. I pray that through you, her wish will be granted. Have you heard of Seath the Scaleless? In legend, he turned against the ancient dragons. He became Lord Gwyn's confidant, was granted dukedom, and was allowed to pursue his research. At the Regal Archives, he immersed himself in research on scales of immortality. The one thing that he did not have. But his very research drove him mad. The Archives became a dungeon, a place for sinister experiments. Now, nobody dares even approach the Duke's forbidden archives. It looms over this land high atop the mountain. But I should warn against even an approach.